We basically conceived Google Preferred because we heard from the television marketplace and TV buyers. They needed a simple, easy way to figure out what content on YouTube was the most important for them to buy. And as we, I think, grew up as a company, especially YouTube, we've seen the evolution of lots of different types of content that, you know, maybe perceived from a TV point of view as being television-like. Comparatively, maybe it didn't look the same, but they knew the audience was there and it was as engaging. But because of the fragmented landscape that we have on the web today, which I think YouTube's an example, it's not just about one or two hit shows, it's about hundreds of channels, hundreds of creators that have made individual connections with users and an audience that they actually own. They own that audience, they talk to that audience every day, and they develop content in a new way. So we said, well, how can we make it easy for TV buyers to understand the platform without going into a pitch about 100 different channels or 1,000 different creators? And so, like Google and what we do, we created an algorithm. And our algorithm enabled us to look at two things, passion and popularity. So we obviously wanted to know what was the most popular by the size. So we looked at metrics like watch time and repeat viewership of a channel to determine how much time do people spend and do they have an active subscriber base? Does this base come back day in and day out because they love this creator and they love the content? The second thing we wanted to look at was passion. One thing that the rating systems of today that measure television don't provide to you is they don't provide you any sort of engagement metrics, right? You don't know that person when they're sitting in front of the TV, how lean in they are. Now, yes, there's different things that are being done, and I know Twitter's doing some interesting things, and there's some great data out there that you can find, but we knew that we could own this metric, and we could provide more insight into the actual engagement that the channels provide. So how often is the content shared? How often are users commenting on it? And how often are they liking it and interacting with it? And so we took those two, put them together, created a scoring system, which we call the preference score, and then we essentially looked across the landscape of across 18 categories we thought marketers would be interested to connect with those users, and then we took the top scores from all those categories, parsed it off, and brought it to the upfront last year. So we really sort of incubated the offering for the advertisers. And I think now that we've done it, we've certainly learned a lot of insights about the channels ourselves that help us inspire the creative community to optimize towards those things. It's important as a brand to really be in the zeitgeist and be able to connect with users through content that they love and they're passionate about. And sometimes it's hard to define what that is, but I think there's lots of different ways that you can develop insights to try to figure that out. But if I'm a brand today, I don't want to just put my ad in front of Eddie Video. I probably want to put it in a place where the users that are watching are so stimulated and motivated and excited about that piece of creative that they actually lean in more to the advertising. And we've actually seen that when we look at the different scores that we have for channels and the different amounts of brand lift that we see in brand recall. And I think that's something that is really important to a brand to know. And historically, it's been difficult to define with television. You know, you paid a premium for something mostly because the demand was high and because it might have had a high rating. But you didn't necessarily know how much more engaged the audience might have been. And you probably didn't see any measurable way to determine whether your audience actually was more impacted by the ads within the program. So I think now that we have the data to do that, it's important that brands like plan and buy and take that into consideration. I like the intimacy of the event. I think you've got key players represented from different parts of the industry, which I like. I like that there's traditional media. I like that there is agency representation, technology players. And so I feel like the combination of that and, you know, having an intimate environment to actually just casually discuss the industry, what are your thoughts, what do you see, it's a really good way to share ideas and get creative. So I really enjoy the event and being here.